About 100 years have passed since the first motor race in the world was held in France. Motor racing and cars have a shared history of progress. Mitsubishi set out to join the ranks of motor vehicle manufacturers in 1917. The company's first product was the Mitsubishi Model A, an approximately 30 horsepower vehicle. In 1960, the company introduced an entirely original Mitsubishi vehicle, the Mitsubishi 500. 2 years later, in order to measure the car's performance against world competition, Mitsubishi entered the Macau Grand Prix for the first time. And that's where the history of Mitsubishi Motorsports began. In 1963, the first Japan Grand Prix was held at the Suzuka Circuit. Japanese motorsports came of age. In 1966, the Colt 1000F was introduced. This car was a sibling of the Colt 800, which had drawn a great deal of attention as the first Japanese fastback. In the following year, the Colt was exported to Australia for the first time. In order to raise awareness of Mitsubishi motor vehicles, a decision was made to enter a Colt in the Southern Cross International Rally. An Australian driver, Doug Stewart, greatly assisted Mitsubishi Motors in undertaking the new and unknown challenge of international rallying. The Colt had a 1,000cc, 55 horsepower engine. It finished fourth overall and was the winner in its class. The next year, the Colt 1100F was entered. This came third overall and gave Mitsubishi its second consecutive class victory. Mitsubishi's first steps in international rallying were a great success. In order to win races and rallies, it is first essential to develop the technology that produces high-performance vehicles. In 1965, Mitsubishi made a firm commitment to motorsports. From that year, Mitsubishi began to focus on formula car races and embarked on the development of high-performance engines and chassis. In the 1971 Japan Grand Prix, Mitsubishi entered a Colt F2000. This had an R39B engine, the basis of the later Saturn engine. Mitsubishi won overall victory, beating the car said to be the top machine in the world at that time, the Ford Cosworth. Mitsubishi technology now ranked among the world's best. In 1972, the focus of Mitsubishi's motorsports activities changed from formula car races to international rallying, where the overall performance of production vehicles is put to the test. With the world's strongest teams as competitors, the objectives were to demonstrate the superiority of Mitsubishi by winning and to make use of the know-how gained by competing in the development of production vehicles. The team welcomed Andrew Cowan, an experienced international rally driver. In him were placed the hopes of the Mitsubishi team for overall victory in the Southern Cross Rally. In that year, the Nissan factory team brought to the event its experience in the Safari Rally, and the rally was a neck-and-neck contest between the 2400cc Datsun and the 1600cc Mitsubishi Galant. The Galant had a Saturn engine that had demonstrated its value in formula car racing. It performed steadily from beginning to end, holding on to first place and eventually beating the Datsun by a big 24-minute margin. It was a memorable overall victory. In 1973, Mitsubishi launched the Lancer 1600 GSR. The basic idea in designing this car was that it would be the most powerful competitor in international rally. This Lancer combined an extremely rigid, lightweight monocoque body with the Saturn engine that had demonstrated great reliability in the Gallon. The team had a new member, Joginder Singh, who had been a dominant force in the Safari Rally. Mitsubishi set its sights on a second consecutive Southern Cross victory. The Lancer handled superbly and benefited from the mid-speed torque of the Saturn engine. The Lancer was out on its own in front from day one. Covered 3,200 kilometers in 4 days. Lancers led all the way, achieving a sweep of the top 4 places overall and giving Mitsubishi a perfect victory in the Lancers' debut event. In 1974, the Lancer aimed for the jewel in the World Rally Championship crown, the East Africa Safari Rally. The world's most famous cars and drivers gathered for the start in Nairobi in their quest to identify the world's top rally car. Driving for the Peugeot team, Hannu Mikkola. For Porsche, Bjorn Boldegaard. Driving for Mitsubishi, Joginder Singh was making his 17th appearance in the Safari Rally. On April the 11th, the starting flag went down on a rally that would continue for 5 days and cover 5,400 kilometers. The Peugeot 504. The Renault Alpine, the Fiat Abarth, the Lancia Fulvia, the Porsche 911, and the Mitsubishi Lancer. How would the 1600cc Lancer perform against competition that included cars with massive engine displacements of well over 2,000cc's? In torrential rain and flooding, the rally turned into a grim contest. Of the 99 starters, only 16 survived to the end. In the Safari Rally, no time allowance is made for maintenance and refueling. The rally is also a test of a car's fuel economy, and if it should run into trouble, its ease of maintenance. Okay, come on. At the end of the second leg, a Porsche 911 was in the lead. Second was a Lancer. Then came a Datsun 260Z, followed by a Lancia Fulvia, a Fiat Abarth, and a Ford Escort. The competition was intense. In addition to its extremely rigid, lightweight body, the Lancer had an outstanding weight-to-horsepower ratio. It also offered low fuel consumption and a high-performance engine. The Lancer overtook the 2700cc Porsche and moved into first place. In its first appearance in the Safari Rally, the Mitsubishi Lancer scored a stunning overall victory, and the name Lancer achieved instant worldwide fame and recognition. In October of that year, Kenjiro Shinozuka made his international debut for Mitsubishi. Shinozuka was a top driver in Japan and a Mitsubishi employee. By having him compete in the Southern Cross Rally, Mitsubishi was aiming to take effective advantage of his competitive experience in future research and development. In 1976, the 24th Safari Rally. Mitsubishi competes in 4 cars driven by Joginder Singh, Andrew Cowan, Robin Uliati, and Kenjiro Shinozuka. On this occasion, Mitsubishi's greatest rival was Lancia, the manufacturer's champion for two consecutive years. Lancia's ace driver, Sandro Munari. But the Lancia shows its form too late, and the rally turns into a three-way struggle between the Datsun Violet, the Mitsubishi Lancer, and the Peugeot 504. In the middle stages, the Mitsubishi team increases the pressure, and Singh, Bugliatti, and Cowan take the top three positions. The Lancer doesn't allow any other car to get close, and following its success in 1974, Mitsubishi achieves overall safari victory for the second time. The Lancer took a sweep of first, second and third places. Its power made the Lancer king of the rally cars. Shinozuka also did well, finishing sixth in his first appearance. But the Lancer wasn't through yet. Its final scene of victory was the Bandama Rally in West Africa's Ivory Coast. The Lancer overwhelmed the massive 2600cc Peugeot by a margin of almost 4 hours, and Cowan and Singh achieved a 1-2 finish. The Mitsubishi Lancer had accomplished a momentous 8 consecutive victories in international rallies, including the Southern Cross, Safari, and Bandama rallies. With the Colt, Gallon, and Lancer, the focus had been on durability. But now, a new age was dawning. In 1980, 3 years after the Bandama Rally victory, the Lancer EX 2000 Turbo made its first appearance. The Lancer Turbo was developed in order to meet global requirements for a more compact and even more economical car. It was the world's fastest two-wheel drive sedan in the 2000cc class. An original Mitsubishi compact turbocharger with electronic controlled injection gave the Lancer Turbo a very competitive small, light, low-cost engine that generated 170 horsepower at production specifications. This was the 4G63, an engine that continues to be used to this day. The Lancer was to compete in the European rounds of the World Rally Championship with their intense high-speed sprint competition. International rallying at that time was dominated by the Audi Quattro and the Renault 5 and had come to be regarded as a battleground of turbo vehicles. How well would the Lancer do with its all-Japanese turbo engine? The Thousand Lakes Rally had the highest average speed of all the World Rally Championship events. This offered an unbeatable opportunity to compare the performance of turbo vehicles. The event turned into a fierce battle between the two-wheel drive Lancer and the four-wheel drive Audi Quattro. The Audi was a pre-event favorite and an early adopter of a four-wheel drive mechanism. The Lancer was fastest in 11 of 46 competitive sections and finished third overall. The quality of Mitsubishi turbo technology had been demonstrated to the world. Everyday motoring trends now shifted to longer distances and higher speeds. People wanted a vehicle that could offer safe, steady handling at speed. The car launched to meet those requirements was the full-time four-wheel drive Galan VR4. This Galan had a double overhead camshaft 205 horsepower engine. It combined a turbo engine with Mitsubishi's four-wheel drive system, which had a well-established reputation. The Galan offered a high level of safety and stability at high speed. Andrew Cowan now became team director. The 1981 World Rally Champion, Ari Vatanen, was named as a Mitsubishi driver. The Galan VR4 demonstrated its worth only four races after its debut in the 1000 Lakes Rally. This is the Lancia Integrale, which at this stage had won six World Rally Championship events in a row. The Toyota Celica. The Mazda 323. And the Mitsubishi Galan. The rally was a powerful neck-and-neck contest from the beginning. From the second leg, the top contender Lancia, driven by Markku Allen, developed engine trouble, and he retired. He was followed by Toyota's Juha Kankkunen, and then Mitsubishi's Ari Vatanen. The two contenders for victory now were Carlos Sainz for Toyota and Mikael Eriksson driving for Mitsubishi. The Galan displayed superior high-speed handling stability and firm cornering. It eventually overtook the Toyota. In only its fourth World Rally Championship event, the Mitsubishi Galan had defeated the supposedly invincible Lancia and won its first overall victory. In the same year, the final event, the RAC Rally in Britain, turned into a battle between two Japanese manufacturers, Mitsubishi and Toyota. The Mitsubishi team decided to play a waiting game in the first half of the rally and occupied fourth and fifth positions overall. Then on the final day, the Galans gave the contest everything they had, caught up with Toyota, and completed a fantastic victory from behind. In only 1 year of World Rally Championship competition, the Galan had been the overall winner of two rallies, the 1000 Lakes and the RAC. And this time, the world had seen the quality of Mitsubishi's four-wheel drive technology.
Two in a row, how'd you feel?
Fantastic, absolutely fantastic. Terrific. Can't put it in words.
The Galan proved itself a formidable competitor in endurance events as well. For three consecutive years, it was overall winner of the Ivory Coast Rally in West Africa. The Galan not only handled well at high speed, it was also a very durable vehicle. Chinozuka became the first Japanese winner of a World Rally Championship event. In 1992, the Lancia Evolution was launched. With this car, Mitsubishi was aiming to enhance its prestige as a motor vehicle manufacturer with a car that was a distillation of 25 years of rallying experience. The new Lancia would take Mitsubishi to the next stage in the unending evolution of motor vehicles. The car had a compact and extremely reliable lightweight body, combined with the 2000cc double overhead camshaft engine that had been perfected in the Galan. The engine had been beefed up and was now the most powerful in the class at 250 horsepower. The Lancia Evolution made its debut at the Monte Carlo Rally in 1993. In its rallying activities, Mitsubishi adopts an integrated system. Engineers from the research department go to the rally itself, and the know-how that they gain firsthand is fed back swiftly into the enhancement of production cars. In 1994, the Lancer Evolution 2 was introduced. As well as bringing production cars a 260 horsepower engine, this Lancer featured even better aerodynamics and high-speed handling stability. Also, in order to improve cornering performance, an electronic active control four-wheel drive system was developed. This was incorporated in vehicles from 1995. This enhancement soon demonstrated its value in the snowy Swedish rally. With its outstanding handling, Lancer achieved a 1-2 finish. In the Safari rally, the Evolution 3 made its first appearance. This featured even better aerodynamics and a secondary air supply system for the engine. Production vehicles now boasted a 270 horsepower engine. The sixth event of the year was the Rally Australia, the toughest of all the World Rally Championship events and a great opportunity to seek the further evolution of the Lancer. The competition was fierce, and after 3 days and 1,200 kilometers, a Mitsubishi and a Subaru were locked together in first place with identical times. The Lancer's active control four-wheel drive system took full advantage of its four-wheel drive performance, enabling the Lancer to adapt to any type of road conditions. And the Lancer emerged the overall victor, beating out the Subaru by 19 seconds. This victory underlined Mitsubishi's steady technological advance. The same year saw the holding of the 8th Asia Pacific Rally Championship. In a region where demand for cars has been rocketing, the standard of rally competition has been getting tougher with each passing year. Mitsubishi has been an enthusiastic participant since the championship was first held and has contributed to the promotion and enhancement of motorsports in the Asian region. Proton of Malaysia and Hyundai of the Republic of Korea are among the new Asian powers emerging strongly in recent years. The Lancer records its first victory this year in Malaysia, the third rally of the championship. The Lancer wins again in Australia. This is a double title, counting also towards the World Rally Championship. The Hong Kong-Beijing rally takes the competitors 3,700 kilometers across China in 7 days. In this rally, steady, high-speed handling is essential, and so is durability. The Lancer is overwhelmingly fast throughout and takes first and second places overall. The last event is the Rally of Thailand. The Lancer once again displays consistent power and once again takes first and second places overall. Mitsubishi wins the Asia Pacific Rally Championship title for the fourth time. In 1996, based on 3 years of technical progress following its debut in 1993 at Monte Carlo, the Lancer demonstrated its superlative quality in every rally context throughout the world. The Lancer was entered for every event in the World Rally Championship and the Asia Pacific Rally Championship. 13 rallies in all. The first event of the season is the Swedish Rally. Here, the Lancer shows off its exceptionally steady handling and takes overall victory. In the Safari Rally, Mitsubishi battles past Subaru for its first victory in 20 years and third altogether. This rally offers proof of the Lancer's durability and underlines the exceptional quality of its overall performance. The Rally Argentina is contested over a demanding course in the foothills of the Andes Mountains. It's said that this event tests the reliability of a car and the experience of a driver. But Mitsubishi, in its first appearance, comes away with overall victory yet again. Winding roads are the main feature of the Rally New Zealand. Here too, Mitsubishi takes another overall victory, and this time a newcomer, Richard Burns, is at the wheel. It's his first victory in a big event. The 1000 Lakes Rally in Finland is known for high-speed jumps. In this, the ninth rally of the year, the Lancer enjoys 4 days of trouble-free perfection. Mitsubishi wins again. That makes 5 overall victories already. Tommy Mäkinen is now virtually assured of winning the World Rally Championship driver's title. The Rally Australia is known for very slippery conditions. People here talk about ball-bearing roads. But the Lancer's active control four-wheel drive system produces a very convincing performance, and Mitsubishi gets its 6th overall victory of the season. A dream come true for Tommy Mäkinen, the World Rally Championship driver's title. The Hong Kong-Beijing Rally crosses the vast spaces of China. This is a 7-day event that demands high-speed durability. Mitsubishi wins, taking its 2nd consecutive manufacturer's title in the Asia-Pacific Rally Championship. This win means that Mitsubishi has been overall victor on each of the 5 continents where this year's rallies are held. Mitsubishi technology is put to the test in the world's most demanding rallies. And now the next generation is ready to meet that challenge. The Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution 4. Thank you.